Welcome back to Pastry Maestra. I'm Teresa, and today I'm making chocolate marshmallows on a stick. Marshmallow is a sugar-based confectionery that today typically consists of sugar, water, and gelatin, whipped to a squishy consistency, molded into small cylindrical pieces, and coated with cornstarch. This is the modern version of a medicinal confection made from a plant called Altea officinalis, which is a mellow plant species that grows in marshes and other damp areas of Europe, North Africa, and Asia. History of marshmallows goes back as early as 2000 BC. Ancient Egyptian gods and royalty used the root of the plant to soothe coughs and sore throats and to heal wounds. In the early to mid 1800s, the marshmallow appeared in France, where the owners of small candy stores would whip the sap from the mellow root into a fluffy candy, which was called pâte de guimauve. It usually took 2 days to prepare the finished product, so the production was small and expensive. Because of that, in the late 1800s, candy makers started looking for a new process and discovered the starch mogul system, in which trays of modified cornstarch had the mold firmly pushed down in them to create cavities within the starch. The cavities were then filled with the whipped marshmallow sap mixture and allowed to cool or harden. Today, the marshmallow typically consists of sugar, water, air, and the whipping agent, usually a protein. Now, in my video, I'm dipping my marshmallows in the chocolate and sprinkling them with sugar sprinkles. So this time, I encourage you to forget about counting calories and just enjoy. Okay, let's make some chocolate marshmallows on a stick. As usual, the recipe is on my site and the link is down below. First thing I'm gonna do is prepare a 20 by 20 centimeters, which is 8 by 8 inches baking pan, and line it with parchment paper. Then I will brush the paper with oil to prevent it from sticking to marshmallows. Next thing I will do is mix sifted powdered sugar with cornstarch and set aside until needed. I will put powdered gelatin and cold water into a bowl of a stand mixer and stir well to combine. I will leave it for about 10 minutes to bloom. While the gelatin is blooming, I'm gonna put sugar and water into a saucepan and stir to hydrate the sugar. I will put the lid on and cook it until it boils. My syrup is boiling. I will remove the lid and add glucose syrup. I'm gonna insert the probe of my digital candy thermometer into the syrup and cook it until it reaches 114 degrees centigrade, which is 237 degrees Fahrenheit. My syrup is ready. I've started mixing the gelatin and now I will pour the hot syrup inside. I will mix on high speed until the mixture cools down. After a couple of minutes, I will add vanilla powder to the mixture. My marshmallow mixture is barely warm, and now I will transfer it into the prepared pan using my silicone spatula. I will level the top of the mixture using slightly oiled spatula. Now I will sift the mixture of powdered sugar and cornstarch on the top. I will leave my marshmallow to set at room temperature overnight. My marshmallow is set. I will sprinkle some mixture of powdered sugar and cornstarch onto a parchment paper. Then I will put the marshmallow slab on top of that. I'm gonna carefully peel off parchment paper from the marshmallow. Then I will sift more sugar and cornstarch mixture on top of the marshmallow slab. Now I'm gonna cut marshmallow with my 2.5 centimeters, which is 1 inch round cutter that I have dipped into the oil. This mixture is very sticky, so I need to be careful and patient. Once I cut my marshmallows, I will roll each one into the sugar and starch mixture to prevent it from sticking. After that, I will put them into the sieve and sift the excess sugar and starch. Next thing I'm gonna do is insert the stick into each marshmallow. You will do that easier if you dip the stick in water before inserting it. I've tempered my white and milk chocolate. I've also prepared colorful toppings for my marshmallows. Now I will dip my marshmallow on a stick halfway or all the way into the chocolate and shake to get rid of the excess chocolate. Once the excess chocolate drips down, I will sprinkle some toppings onto the chocolate while it is still sticky. I will repeat this until I decorate all the marshmallows. Then I will stick them in baking weights, which will hold them and prevent them from sticking to one another. There, my colorful marshmallows are done and the party can begin. Have fun!
Oh baby, you are so sweet, so delicious and yummy, so good to eat. I wanna lick you, feel your sweetness on my lips. Forever and ever, you'll stay on my hips.
I'm Teresa. Thanks for watching my video. I hope you liked it. If you want to stay in touch, follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And of course, visit my site where you can find elaborate posts with lots of pictures, additional information, and recipes that follow my every video. Also, on my site, you can download my free 365 pages ebook, The Pastry Chef, and maybe buy me a macaron, if you think that I've earned it. Now, before you go, please hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. That really helps a lot. Finally, and this is the most important thing, don't forget to create sweetness every day, because sweetness is happiness. See you in my next video. Bye!